Today we're going to take a look at the water lab and the procedure for this lab. So we'll start off by getting a hot plate and a beaker full of ice and a magnetic stir bar. So set that on the plate and insert a thermometer, and be careful not to let the bulb of the thermometer get too close to the bottom or sides of the beaker. Next, adjust your heat and stirring speed. Usually 80% on the heat and a 4 on the stir speed is adequate, but try to center the beaker on the plate as best as you possibly can. From here, let the ice melt and wait until the water starts to boil. Be sure to record data as required. As the ice melts, adjust the height of the thermometer as needed, and once you're done, be sure to clean up your lab space and don't forget to retrieve your stir bar. Moving on, we'll look at the bubbles in boiling water. So reheat the water until it boils and fill a test tube with water with a stopper in it. Then invert the test tube in the beaker and carefully remove the stopper so that the tube rests on the bottom of the beaker. Be sure not to remove the test tube from the water during this process. We now want to start trapping some of the bubbles in the test tube. This might take some coaxing, but lifting and moving the test tube seems to work pretty well. You should see something like this. Once the tube is filled with gas, you need to quickly remove it from the water and insert a lighted match inside the mouth of the test tube. We'll now look at the bubbles produced from a metal and acid reaction. So for this, bend the magnesium strip so that a small lip forms in the metal and hang it from the inside of the test tube like so. Next, place a beaker over the test tube and very quickly invert both the test tube and the beaker, and again, try to prevent any water from leaking out. Afterwards, your setup should look something like this. Now, carefully add water. And then add the hydrochloric acid. Make sure a reaction is occurring in the beaker once you add the acid. Unlike before, it may take some coaxing to trap the bubbles in the test tube. And once again, once the tube is filled with gas, you're going to want to remove it from your water acid solution and then insert a lighted match inside the mouth of the test tube. In the last section of this lab, we'll be adding salt to the boiling water, so set up your lab station like you had it before with a hot plate, beaker, thermometer, and a clamp. And once the water starts to boil, add your salt, but be careful not to add all of your salt at once, and then record your data as necessary. So with that, we'll wrap up the water lab, and thank you for watching.